Well, yeah, that's the thing, he's not even here.
In closed session, we learned that the county was a private citizen, offered us some land, and wanted to know if we would like to purchase it, and we agreed not to purchase this property. So that was the action that was taken. We have no interest in purchasing any more property at this point. So that was the action that was taken. Okay? Okay. Next is commissioners' comments.
I would like to bring up the possibility of, with, we're going to be in the new courthouse June 11th, and I think it would make a better place than what we're meeting in right here. All the wiring and everything. Am I right in saying that all we got to do to move there is to move the cameras, right?
We have to move the cameras and have to pull some cabling for the cameras. And so we could, take about 30 days to get what we need, plus some additional cameras.
Now's the time to do it if we're going to do it. Am I right?
That's entirely up to the board.
You've already got in the walls.
We got the conduit run. The microphones have already been wired for if you were to do it for the court.
Here, all the people that come here cannot be in the same room. Up there, they would be in the same room.
It's standing room only now. I'm opposed to moving. I don't mind voting on it, getting it over with. I think it's been part of an agenda all along without proper discussion. I'm willing to vote on it right now and get it over with. I'm opposed to moving that.
I would like to go look at it before I vote on anything. I mean, and see what it's going to be like.
It's a showplace. I'm telling you.
Oh, I know that. I mean, I would like to see.
It really is a showplace.
I guess we need the numbers for the cost to do it, too. I think that would have to be a deciding factor for me.
And I mean, I can't vote on it tonight. I would like to go look at it and to make sure that that's what we want to do at that point. So that's my feelings on it. So.
Yeah. Since we don't have to set this agenda.
Well, maybe we need to get Richard Craig to give us a tour or something. Can we do that?
Anytime. Well, Tim just mentioned we could either go before the next meeting and take a look.
I think that would be good and get some numbers together. What you're talking about. I mean, it is going to cost to move. So.
There is a little bit of cost to move, but the equipment that we have would be able to be basically transferred. But if the board's agreeable, would you like to meet 30 minutes before our next meeting at the old courthouse and then have a tour?
Sure.
But you'll remind us of that, right?
We'll remind you.
Send that. We'll send it pre-meeting. 30 minutes.
Did we sign this? We did. I read it on it. Yes, we have not signed this. Okay. Any other commissioner comments?
I did want to bring up the other. We wanted to ensure we've been requested by the ACC for a joint meeting on May 4th and wanted to ensure that that was okay.
Is that a decided day now?
If agreeable with this board, it will be. I think it's at 11, starting at 11.
Is that May the 4th?
Yeah, I'm going to be a few minutes late. Okay.
What meeting place?
I don't know if they said. My guess is
just meet maybe in the area where they come in there at the front.
Yeah. We'll clarify the location or the room.
We have a groundbreaking tomorrow.
At Kitty.
If y'all folks want to come, it's at 2:00.
2:00.
I think one of the things we've got to discuss is what are you going to do with this room if we did go up here? My understanding you're going to turn this into a courtroom. I was thinking about it, right? And that's going to be an expense factor as well. So there's a whole lot of angles to this whole deal.
Okay. Any more commissioners' comments?
Yeah, I'd like to ask a question. I know I've asked it in budget, and I still don't feel like I've heard a nailed down answer yet. What are we doing with this performance-based budgeting scenario that we've asked about? I found a memo here in what I brought tonight when I was accumulating something else
report done April of a year ago. I mean, we requested this a year ago from Davidson County, and that's Tim and I went down to Davidson. When did we go down there, Tim?
About 2 years ago.
Oh, way more than 2 years ago. Well, let me state this here. They had Davidson County started off with seven departments. They went from 7 to 10 to 11 to 12 to 13 to 15 to 15 departments from 2002 to 2003 to 2008 to 2009, about 6 years. And unless I'm adding these figures wrong, they've accumulated about $8 million in savings as a result of the successes of performance-based budgeting. And I think they took over from, got their theory from Catawba, and even last meeting's debate, not debate, but discussion of the EMS, you know, they had two in-house people doing collections for EMS, two. Not the seven, not the six, not the four, two. And then they took it to three, and I just casually asked the guy, so well, now how'd you go to three? What was the deal? He said, oh, we paid for that with the money we saved from performance-based budgeting. I thought, more proof of the pudding. But what's that? I mean, no offense. I've been talking about this for a long time.
We have Tim and Susan that are kind of heading this up for us, so I'll
As of January the 1st, they, each department, and there's six of them from here that are, it's EMS, library, GIS, maintenance, DSS.
And recreation.
And recreation. So those are the six departments that are involved in it. By January 1st, they came up with their broad measurements and broad goals. So here's what our goals are that we hope to achieve, and here's how we're going to measure those. And those were broad. So between January and July 1st, this coming July 1st, they're supposed to be really kind of tracking those things and refining them so that come July 1st, they'll have specific goals in place and specific ways to measure those goals, whether they achieve those goals or not. Those will then be tracked from July 1st of 2011 till June 30th of 2012. Also during that time period, we will develop a monetary policy that whatever savings that they see within their budgets, now those savings may not be tied to their goals and measurements. They may be just they find savings, but because they found savings in their budget, then they get to keep, and the monetary policy will be adopted, will be formulated over the next year to determine, okay, if they have savings, how much stays within their department, how much comes back to the county's general fund. If they keep it in their department, how many years can they carry this over to build it up if there's a piece of equipment they need to buy and it'll take them 5 or 10 years to accumulate enough or whatever that is. We'll bring that back to y'all. The board will be the one that will approve that monetary policy. You know, some places have done, you know, bonuses for employees. I'm not saying ours would include that.
I think we should include that in.
Yeah, I mean, that may be something that the board would choose to do, but those are the type of things that could be done with that money. That will then will take effect a year from this July is then when we will have ended that first year's period, and at that point is when the whatever savings are realized, then it could be applied to either those departments or brought back to the general fund. So that's where we are in the process.
I hope we can speed it up.
Well, I mean, it's not really, that's how you have to track it based on budget years and all of that. So it's not really a, that's just kind of how it tracks out.
I do. Yeah. It's my personal belief we've been slow on it, though, and that's just my opinion. And I've got one more thing while you're here.
Yes, sir.
Yesterday, sorry, it was on Sunday, I asked to see this map here, the schematic here on the jail prison maintenance where we're putting in the
community corrections,
whatever it is. And my concern here was, you know, I had talked with the sheriff just in casual conversations about expanding as recent as, you know, a month or so ago. You know, we talked about putting modular units in there, or, you know, what it would take, how many more people we could take. Just casual conversation, nothing, no plan to put it into play or make motions for it, anything like that, just casual. And then Friday, he sits there and tells me in a nice way, you know, we were shooting the bull about something, and it just came out. Oh, I tell you what it was. It was something, and we possibly ought to do a resolution on this, that the state's considering making us house misdemeanors that we no longer have. I mean, we don't house right now. And that, you know, we don't have anywhere to put them. And that's what led us into talking about this again, you see. And he said, oh, well, we can't expand over there because of this, you see. Is there no way to turn that parking lot around? It's the first time I've seen this. I believe I would remember this. And you say you've shown it to us. I believe you. I'm not.
That's right. That the map you have there, the site plan you have in front of you, when Allie Williams, Carmen, and King did their site survey, and I think they analyzed three or four different locations. The one they recommended was at Prison Camp Road. In the report that they gave you, which was a bound report, they had three different. They had three different site plans, okay. And that site plan was included in there, which shows the proposed layout for the project.
How many people are going to work in that building?
There'll be 30. It's in the upper 30s, 38, somewhere in that number. Now, the site plan that you have there that was given to the board at that time, and that was back, I think, in September, this past September, the site plan that you had at the last meeting, it changed somewhat, but it's still, I mean, it was pretty much that we changed, reconfigured the location of the building and all that. As far as parking goes, they have 30-some employees. They have, I think, 30-some state vehicles because they have vehicles, state vehicles, but they're not allowed to take those home, so they have to leave those on site. So at any time, you've got, you know, 80 spaces for that, plus you've got spaces for the public to come. So you're looking at 100, and I think there are 130-some spaces in that property, which is probably somewhat equivalent or close to what they currently have as far as number of parking spaces. So as far as saving space and reconfiguring, I think the Allie Williams, Carmen King is about maximize the property there in trying to get the number of spaces they need plus the size of the building that we need. So I don't know that there's really much configuring to that.
And plus you have to deal with all your other requirements from the state that says how you run off waters.
That's correct.
They have to redraw that. That's probably another $20,000 to redraw.
Very well could be. There's two drainage areas that ponds. They're not real deep by 18 inches, but so that's been done. So reconfiguring it, I don't know if they were to reconfigure, if you could really gain enough area to behind the.
Well, my point is it county management's opinion now that it would be physically impossible to add onto that place over there?
The only place that you possibly, because I looked at it today, is on the front of it, between the road. And I don't know what the setbacks are over there, whether it's even possible. That's the only space that would really be, could be looked at, would be in the front of the jail. Between it and Prison Camp Road, and that is a, you know, whether you could add on, that would be the area that would be left to, if you could possibly.
What are the lands available? Somebody told me there's another lot over there, right?
The state does have additional land over there. It's DOT, and it would just have to see what was available from them. Hopefully, you know, one of the legislative goals we did have as a county. Remember when we talked about that was the discussion of misdemeanors, and we have sent that resolution, well, legislative goals to the county association, but also to our local delegation. So we hopefully that'll work out as well. But I think we do have some capacity still left at the jail, our main jail now, that maybe we wouldn't need to expand as soon, even if the misdemeanors did come.
Well, I admit, you know, I dropped the ball by not asking this question then. At least I'm asking it now, better late than never, I suppose. I believe if I'd seen that, I don't know why I didn't see it. Evidently, I just was derelict my duties for that particular packet. Was it ever a consideration that we might want to expand that? I mean, anybody ever discuss any possible place?
We had some discussions with the sheriff before we moved forward with this site, and he kind of, he did sign off on a site plan, you know, acknowledging, yeah, that he knows that was going to be the size of the building and the general layout.
Right.
So we wanted to make sure that he was comfortable with what was being proposed. And again, didn't want to take away all of his options, but he did agree that he, I don't know if that was his first choice, but he was comfortable with what was being proposed.
Was he under the understanding we'd be landlocked or that we would not be able to expand that facility jail-wise?
As far as deep discussions, we really didn't have those discussions. It just said, here's a site plan of what we're proposing because there's some demolition of some of those older buildings. You know, we had to move some of the evidence room around and find new places for them.
I understand that, but no offense, you can sign off on the building that we're talking about, but you're not signing off on the theory that you can't expand the jail.
Well, I mean, I think from the site plan that he signed off on, it was apparent that there wasn't going to be much room between his existing jail and where the fence is going to be dividing the two properties. That there wasn't sufficient amount to add. I mean, it was apparent from the site plan that he approved, that we showed to him, that he signed off on, that there wouldn't be much, you know, much room left. So,
well, I don't want to beat a dead horse, but I'm going to throw one more whip at it. If I had been told myself for my vote that, you know, I'd had to have somebody say, look me square in the eye, say, we're not going to be able to expand that jail anymore if we do this, and then me make a decision based on that. I don't think I ever heard that. No, matter of fact, no one ever heard that. And that's why I brought it up now, and again, my conscience is clear, but I think more questions could have been asked by me and more things could have been told by y'all to us. And that's my personal belief. That's all I have.
Okay.
Thank you.
Any other announcements that anybody has? If not, we are adjourned.
Thank you for tuning in to the Alamance County Commissioners Meeting. Meetings of the Commissioners Board occur at 7 p.m. on the first and third Monday of each month in the Commissioners' Chambers on the second floor of the County Office Building located at 124 West Elm Street in Graham. Changes to the meeting schedule will be posted on the Commissioners' website at www.alamance-nc.com. You can watch the most recent meeting of the County Commissioners on the second and fourth Wednesday of each month on Time Warner's local public access channel beginning at 10 o'clock p.m. You can also watch recordings of the most recent meeting and past meetings by going to our website at www.alamance-nc.com. Please visit our website for more information on watching commissioner meetings online. For technical questions about this meeting's online or television broadcast, please contact our county webmaster at webmaster@alamance-nc.com. Please note that this address is for technical questions only. Questions or comments regarding the content of commissioner meetings may be made to the commissioners themselves. You can find their contact information at the Alamance County website at www.alamance-nc.com. Click on the link that says Alamance County Commissioners to visit the commissioners' website, where you can learn about our commissioners, read minutes of past meetings, access agendas, and find other information about our Board of Commissioners. You can also send mail correspondence to the County Commissioners by addressing it to the Alamance County Commissioners, 124 West Elm Street, Graham, North Carolina, 27253. Again, thank you for tuning in to the Alamance County Commissioners Meeting.